Good morning, everyone. We are continuing here in the words of the Mesillas Yesharim. And yesterday, you'll recall the Ramchal taught us a very important lesson in life. And that is that man stands in the center of a great balance in this world. If we are mis'ale, if we elevate ourselves and we increase in our avodas Hashem and we bring kedusha and holiness and mitzvahs into our life, so then we elevate the entire universe together with us. However, if Rachman Litzlan, a person is makalkil themselves, they damage themselves, they distance themselves from HaKadosh Baruch Hu, they drift away from the life of mitzvahs, of closeness to Bari Olam, to the creator of the world, so then we are miskalkil, we get destroyed, and we can bring down the entire world together with us. And therefore he writes today, Kine ilui gadol hu lebrios kulam, the entire creation itself has a great benefit. When they serve the Adam Hashalem, the complete spiritual being, the person over here, who is sanctified with the Kedusha and the sanctity of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, a person who is serving the Ribbono Shel Olam in the proper way, that person is mekudash b'kedushasa yizbarach. He is sanctified. He is elevated with holiness that derives from only one place in this world. It derives directly from Hashem Himself. When you become such a person like that, that we are speaking about, so then the entire Bria, the entire creation, everything under the sun and beyond, it all benefits from being here in this world to be able to serve man's needs. This is like it says in the words of our sages in the Gemara in Chagiga. Hashem created the world, and He said in the opening days of the opening day of creation, "Vayhi or let there be light." Now our sages teach us that that light was not like this incandescent sunlight that we are familiar with. It wasn't electrical light. It wasn't the moonlight. That's not what we're referring to. It was an or haruchni. It was a spiritual light that HaKadosh Baruch Hu brought to this world. And that's really a light which is the expression of the haras ponim, of the light and the revelation of HaKadosh Baruch Hu Shechina here in this world. And the intention was that HaKadosh Baruch Hu was going to fill up the world with this light. And everybody would be able to come and grab onto it and fill themselves up with such or with such light, which would elevate them as well. However, HaKadosh Baruch Hu saw there'll be a lot of Rishayim, there'll be a lot of wicked people in this world, and they're going to misuse the light for the wrong things. You could take Kedusha and you could really make it something that's powerfully used in the negative way. You could take Torah and you could obliterate it and you could make it into something that will twist other people up and bring other people down. And so therefore HaKadosh Baruch Hu said, I can't leave the revelation of my Shechina in this world where people are going to misuse that light and they're going to end up bringing darkness to the world as a result. So what did Hashem do? He took the light and He hid it. And He hid it away, says the Gemara, letzadikim, for the righteous. Righteous people that are living lives of kedusha, of holiness, they would be able to tap in to that ha'aras panim, to that revelation of HaKadosh Baruch Hu Shechina, and they'll bring light to themselves, to their families, to the world around them at large. So says the Gemara the following, when Hashem saw the light that He hid away for the tzaddikim, when HaKadosh Baruch Hu hid away the light for the righteous and He saw that light, samach, He rejoiced. Shenemar, like it says, or tzaddikim yismach, the light of the righteous, which means when the righteous people, they will come and they will tap in to that hidden light that is in this world, the light of kedusha, the light of holiness, of sanctity, of purity, of shechina, so yismach, He will rejoice. Now the simple explanation is that HaKadosh Baruch Hu was very proud that He was able to hide away the light, and therefore He rejoices whenever He sees people in this world that are on the level of righteousness, that they'll be able to tap into it. But the Mefarshim, the commentators also say that one of the things that it means in the verse is that Kevan Shiro or Sheganoza HaKadosh Baruch Hu L'Tzadikim, when the light itself saw that it was hidden away for the tzaddikim, samach, the light itself rejoiced. knowing that there was a cause, knowing that there was a purpose, knowing that there was a way in which it was going to be used in the right way. When the tzaddikim would come and they would access the spiritual lights that HaKadosh Baruch Hu hid away, Samach, the light itself, was rejoicing, because as the Mesillas Yesharim is saying over here, that when a person is the Adam HaShalem, when they are this holy person who's living a life which is so worthy and valuable and redeeming in the eyes of Hashem, so then the entire universe benefits from the life of such a person. And that means that everything that's in the world just simply wants to serve the Kedusha, the holiness and the loftiness and the sanctity and the exaltedness of such a person who has dedicated their life to serving HaKadosh Baruch Hu. We'll leave it here for today. There's so many things to say in the Ramchal, but the bottom line is, let us be inspired to know just how great the koiches, the greatness that we have inside of ourselves, and we have a lifetime, Be'ezda Hashem, to reveal the Kedusha, the holiness inside of ourselves by attaching ourselves to the light of the Ribbono Shel Olam. Have a wonderful day.